Hello everyone and welcome on De Papier de Rêve channel. I'm Ursula and today I will be painting with you some strawberry. I announced it in my Red Currant video 2 weeks ago that I was going to paint a strawberry, and it's today. I'm really happy to be able to paint this this plant just because I can cultivate it here in Barcelona, and I'm really glad to be able to eat my own fruits. So I'm starting this painting by applying a little bit of white gouache on my paper in order to mask some of the paper, because I want the flowers and the stem of the strawberry to be really light on a dark background. So I'm using this masking technique in order to achieve that. The key to make this technique works really well is to use a really thick coat of white gouache and let it dry totally before adding colors. And here my gouache has dried totally, and I'm adding a little bit of watercolor at first. Here I'm using Indontrend Blue and Amazonite Genuine, and a little bit of Nickel Azo Yellow as my colors. And you are not able to see it on the video, but I try to apply really no pressure at all with my brush in order to not disrupt the white gouache too much. It's really, really easy to reactivate the white gouache and make it bleed in the color. So I try to use a really light touch with my brush, and I'm using a particular brush for doing this job. I'm using a synthetic flat brush with really, really soft hair, so that it's really easy to have a light touch with it, and I will not disrupt too much the white gouache underneath my colors. Once I'm happy with this layer of colors, I will add some texture to this layer before letting it dry totally. So here I'm using a little bit of acrylic ink in the color indigo. And also on top of that ink, I'm using a granulating medium so that this ink will separate and make some powdery effect on top of my paper. And I like really this texture. I think it's a really fun way to make texture. And as I want my texture to be a little bit more interesting in the bottom left corner of my page, I'm adding also a plastic wrap on this part of the painting, and I try to infuse some of the color underneath the plastic wrap to make it appear a little bit more stronger and have a lot more texture this way. And now it's time to let this layer dry totally, and then I will remove the white gouache. I didn't film it with my painting this time, but I'm showing you how I'm doing that right now. It's just letting the paper under the sink and rubbing really lightly the gouache, and everything will go away very easily. And before starting a new layer, I have to let it dry again totally, and then I'll be able to continue my work. Now that my paper is totally dry, I can add another layer of details and color on top of my paper. And you can see that all the colors are quite dull right now, just because it was my first layer and watercolor dry quite lighter than when you put it at first. So it's quite normal, but also the fact to put your paper under water, it will wash off a little bit of pigment. It's not a big deal, but you have to know it. The color will fade a little bit. But anyway, you can see all the stem and the flowers of my strawberry, and that's what it's important for me right now, because it's a guide for my future work, and I will be able to make a little bit of negative painting around all of that white lines, so that they will appear a little bit more and there will be more contrast. The masking technique is not an ending, it's a way to achieve a goal. It doesn't matter if it's not perfect at the first layer. You will always have the opportunity to make it better with other layers. And this way, it will make your work a little bit more deeper and enriched it. For all the green colors, I'm staying with the same color as my first layer of color. Indontrend Blue, Amazonite Genuine, and Nickel as a Yellow. It's a winning combo for me lately, just because it's working really great. The colors are really vibrant and rich, and with the touch of Nickel as a Yellow, I can give like the sunlight is eating some part of my painting. So it's a really nice combo for the green right now for me. And for this painting, I'm not using ultramarine blue and I much prefer indontrend blue just because indontrend blue is a little bit deeper than ultramarine blue, and I can get quite deeper and darker green with this color than with ultramarine blue. So for this layer, it's not really about details right now. I just want to give some colors back to my painting and make some part of this painting really, really dark in order to create depth to this painting and some contrast so that my lighter part will appear even more light. Even if I was painting strawberry, I didn't put the red in the first layer. Maybe it was a little bit of a dangerous move to do, but I'm really happy with how it turned out, because all the red is bleeding into the green and everything looks really coherent this way. And now it's time to let this layer dry, and while it dries, I will talk you through my supplies. For the brushes, I'm using an Escoda Ultimo 1-inch and an Escoda Ultimo number 8 Rigger, a silver brush black velvet 1/4 inch in a dagger shape, and a Princeton Neptune 1/4 inch also. For the colors, I'm using Indontrend Blue, Amazonite Genuine, Nickel as a Yellow, Windsor Red, Lavender, and as my acrylic ink, I'm using Golden acrylic ink in Indigo, and my medium, my granulating medium is from Winsor & Newton. My paper today is from Archies in Hot Pressed. For the last layer of this painting, I will focus my work on adding the right detail at the right place, but I want also to deepen a certain area just because the contrast is not enough for me, and I want all the stem and the flower to pop a little bit more than it is right now. I could have in the first and second layer of colors to deepen my color a little bit, to go a little bit darker and quicker, but it's not really a mistake to go a bit light at first, because you can always add some colors if you want. You can always deepen your painting, but you cannot remove paint easily with watercolor. So maybe it's better, in fact, to go slow and steady than to put too much color at first and then regret it. So in order to deepen the area around the stem and the flower, I'm using the negative painting technique. I'm painting around all of this white item. It's quite easy right now just because all the lines are present on my paper already and I just have to follow. But I have to pay attention to make hard edges and soft edges and make a balance between those edges, because it will help me to construct the depth of my painting, and it helps me also to give an impression of strawberry, of a plant, of leaves and stems, more than a realistic version of this plant. And for the last touches on this painting, I will add some lines in the leaves and also the heart of the flower in yellow to add just the right details at the right place, as I say. And it will help to make this painting alive. And when I'm painting white flower, I like to add a tiny bit of shadow with a color like lavender because it's a really soft color and it will help me to just differentiate all the petals from one another and add just the right depth in the flower. And this video is now ending. Thanks for watching and I hope you like it. Please check the blog post for more information about this painting and tell me what you think in the comments. See you soon.